Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Raghuveer. In this class, we will discuss about how to convert NFA to DFA. In our previous classes, when we discussed about non-deterministic finite automata, we clearly discussed about why we need to convert our NFA to DFA, because NFA, we cannot implement NFA in real time. So that's why we need to convert our logic of NFA to DFA. DFA can be implemented. These intuitions are given in our non-deterministic finite automata class. Please follow our playlist from the beginning so that you will have a better understanding of the complete theory of computations. The link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Coming to today's class, it's very easy to convert a non-deterministic finite automata to DFA. Just follow the procedure. You can easily understand, convert the given NFA to DFA. This is our NFA. So this NFA, we already discussed in our examples. This is the NFA to convert that accepts strings that contain last two characters are ones. So last two characters are ones. Initial state is given Q0 and the final state is given as Q2. First, we have to convert this into transition table. When we discussed about deterministic finite automata, we already discussed about what's transition diagram and what transition table. This is transition diagram, this is transition table. So we just convert this diagram into tabular form. How to convert that? On Q0, if you apply input symbol 0, where we are going to move? Q0. On Q0, if you apply input symbol 1, we are moving to Q1 and Q0. So Q0, Q1. On Q1, if you apply input symbol 0, 5. 5 here means we are not moving to any state, empty state, no state. It's not empty state, no state. We are not moving to 5 means we are not moving to any state. And Q2 here means we are moving to the final state. Final state is made it as in the transition table round of some of them, they will follow star symbol, some of them will follow they will round off it. It depends on the textbook. Okay, on Q2, if you apply 0, we are moving to no state. On Q2, if you apply 1, we are moving to no state. This is our transition table for NFA. For the given NFA, you have to convert this into transition table. Now we will convert this transition table into DFA. How to convert that? Let's follow the procedure. So first try to understand how to convert that. So we can easily understand. On Q0, let's start from the Q0 because this is the initial state. So take the NFA transition table. On Q0, if you apply 0, we are moving to Q0 state. The same thing right here. Q0, if you apply 0, we are moving to Q0 state. On Q0, if you apply 1, we are moving to Q0, Q1 state. So Q0, Q1 state. So for the DFA table, we have generated one transition. Which transition we have generated? Q0. So the below table is not yet constructed, only the first line is constructed. Now coming to this first line, this Q0, already transition has been mentioned, but this combination of this Q0 and Q1, this is new possibility. This will be considered as another state in DFA. Q0, Q1, combination of this, we call it as another state in a DFA. So Q0, Q1 is a next state in our DFA. So how to identify the next state, Q0, Q1. So take the Q0 and Q1. Q0, if you apply 0, which state you are going? Q0 state. Q1, if you apply 0, which state you are going? No state. So union of these two states, Q0 union no state. What's the union means? Combination of all. So Q0 union 5 means Q0. That's why output is Q0. The same way, Q0, if you apply 1, Q0, Q1 state. Q1, if you apply 1, we are going to Q2 state. Union of these two. What is this union of these two? Q0, Q1, Q2. So our new state is Q0, Q1, Q2. So Q0, already transition has been mentioned. Q0, Q1. Transition has been mentioned. Q0, transition has been mentioned. Q0, Q1, Q2. So this combination is not yet considered up to now. So take Q0, Q1, Q2 as new state here in DFA. Okay, Q0, Q1, Q2 will be considered as a new state. Now let's write the transition for Q0, Q1, Q2. Q naught, if you apply 0, we are moving to Q naught state. Q1, 0, 5 state. Q2, 0, 5, empty state. Union of all these three is Q naught. That's why we have written it as Q naught. Q naught, similarly, Q naught if you apply 1, Q naught Q1. If you apply 1, Q2. Q2 if you apply 1, empty state. Union of all these is Q naught, Q1 and Q2. So Q naught, Q1 and Q2 is our next state. Is there any combinations not yet discussed about the transition of the DFA left? No, we did not left any of the new combinations. Understand it properly. Q naught transition has been mentioned. Q naught, Q1 transition has been mentioned. Q naught transition has been mentioned. Q naught, Q1, Q2. Yes, transition has been mentioned. So Q naught transition has been mentioned. Q naught, Q1, Q2 transition has been mentioned. So we have to construct our DFA till no new combinations are generated. Up to that, you have to generate the DFA. How to decide the final state? Initial state is Q naught. Here we are having final state as Q2. So in whatever combination we are having Q2, it should be considered as the final state. This combination is having a Q2, so this is considered as the final state. If this combination Q2 is present in multiple states, both are considered as the final states. This is how we construct the NFA to DFA. Now construct the transition diagram for our DFA. So this is our final DFA which we got after converting our NFA to DFA transition diagram. So Q naught, if you apply 0, we are moving to Q naught state. That's why we stay on Q naught. Q naught, if you apply 1, we are moving to Q naught Q1 state. Q naught Q1 is a combination of a new state. So Q naught Q1 state, we apply here to 1. The same way, Q naught Q1, if you apply 0, we are moving to Q naught state. Q naught Q1, if you apply 1, Q naught Q1 Q2 state. This is the state. Q naught Q1 Q2 state, it's considered as final state. The same way, Q naught Q1 Q2, if you take it as 0, we are moving to Q naught state. Q naught Q1 Q2, if you apply 1, we are moving to Q naught Q1 Q2 state. The discussion about how to accept the last two characters as ones, the same DFA we have constructed when in the DFA examples, we already constructed this logic, and in the NFA examples also we constructed it. That's why we have chosen the same examples for the understanding purpose. So it's very easy to convert our NFA into DFA. Just follow the procedure. You have to take the union of that. And one more important point you have to understand, if you want to write the exams, this is how you will show the construction. Okay, this is for the sake of marks, not we are not explaining any new concept. How to write the transition? Delta dash Q naught comma 0. Delta dash is used as a DFA transition equal to delta of Q naught comma 0. Delta means NFA transition. In order to distinguish that, given different names, you can give any other names. Delta means NFA transition. Delta dash means DFA transition. Q naught 0 is Q naught. Delta dash of Q naught 1 is whatever the procedure we followed, we are making it as a statement. That's it. Delta dash Q naught 1 is delta of Q naught 1 is equal to Q naught Q1. And the next point you have to understand, delta dash of Q naught Q1 is the new state in DFA. Comma 0 means delta of Q naught 0, NFA, Q naught 0, union, delta of Q1 0. Combination of these both, union, we got Q naught. The same way, delta dash of Q naught Q1 on 1 is a delta of Q naught 1, union delta of Q1 1. Q naught 1 means Q naught Q1, Q1 1 means Q2. Combination union is Q naught Q1 Q2. This is how you have to continue the remaining transition also. For the sake of marks, you have to show all this. For not for gate and remaining things. And one more important point you have to understand. After converting our NFA to DFA, what are the maximum possible number of states you will get after converting our NFA to DFA? Suppose in our example, our NFA is having three states, Q0, Q1, Q2. So how we are considering this? possibilities, number of possibilities, combinational possibilities, combination possibilities. Q naught, Q1, this is one possibility. Q0, Q2, this is another possibility. Q1, Q2, this is another possibility. Q0, Q1, Q2, this is another possibility. Q0, one possibility. Q1, Q2. 5 means empty state. We are not moving to any other state. So in this example, we did not show the example about 5. So why we consider it as a state, you will understand in our next example when we discuss about NFA to DFA conversion for the dead state example. Okay, then you will understand. So phi is one state, means we are not moving to any state, is one state. So combination is 2 power number of states. 2 cube, how many states are there? NFA, 3 states are there. So 2 cube is equal to 8. These are the maximum possibilities. So if you convert our NFA to DFA, how many number of states it may get? These are the maximum possibilities. 2 cube means 8 different states may come. So no need to get the 8 states. That is the point you have to understand. So maximum possibility is 8 states. Okay, hope you understand the concept. If you have any questions regarding the concept, please post your questions in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.